Hello guys, and welcome back to another video of Architects 3DP. In last week's video, we built this amazing shelving solution to set up our 3D printer farm. For that we used 9 IKEA lag tables that cost only 10 euros each, and assembled them with each other using some custom 3D printed parts that I designed. If you still have not, you should definitely watch the episode 1 of this series clicking in the top right corner of the video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to pass from here to here. But before starting, make sure you are subscribed to my YouTube channel Architects3DP, clicking here in this little icon. If you do it, you will help me creating new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. Since I built my 3D printing farm shelving last week, my workshop is extremely organized if we compare it with how it was before. But there's still one thing that is not optimized enough, and it's that I usually check if everything is working fine in the middle of the print and so on. I suppose you do it as well. Especially the first layer adhesion is very important, and I used to make sure it sticked well before continuing with the print. What I have experienced this week is that these quality check tasks I used to make were more difficult, since the print area was quite dark due to the structure of the tables, so I had to use the LED flash of my phone to be able to see the nozzle. That's why I decided to install some kind of lighting solution. And now I'm gonna explain you what I did, so you can do the same if you want. First, I bought from Amazon this cheap and powerful LED strip. It comes in a 5 meter long format and will generate a pure white light. By the way, all the products used in this video will be linked down in the description, so you can buy them from Amazon from our affiliate links. Alright, so once it's clear, I'm gonna start with assembly. My idea is to make 3 separate installations, one for each 3D printer. Since the LED strip that I bought is using 12 volts, the same that our 3D printers, I will connect each LED installation to the power supply of each 3D printer. But an important fact to take into account is that the cable going from the LED strip to the power supply of the 3D printer will be interrupted 2 times, one by a power switch and one by a power connector. Since if we have to take the 3D printer out, we will have to disassemble everything. So starting with the installation, we are going to cut the LED strip in portions. If you look at it, you will see that every 5 centimeters it has a mark where we'll be able to cut and weld the 2 cables to it. The LED strip package included a couple connectors to extend the LED strip, and also with a power cable. It is basically a plastic piece that will attach the LED strip to the cable with a simple click. The solution is easy, but I prefer to get a better visual result. So I'm going to just weld the 2 cables to the LED strip using some tin, and later covering it with a heat shrink tubing. So back in our extractor, if we measure the bottom of the table, we can see that we could cut the LED strip right here around 45 centimeters long. We are actually going to cut 2 portions, since it will provide twice the light, which is really convenient. Once we have the 2 separated portions, I'm going to weld them together using some kind of 2 wires cable. In my case, I'm going to use this small 10 centimeters portion and weld it to both portions of the LEDs. Be careful and connect the cables without crossing them. Finally, I will use this heat shrink tubing to cover the union and fix it in place. Alright, so first part done. Now I'm going to check if it fits in place, and as you can see, it fits perfectly. Next, we just have to make the installation that connects the LED strip to the power supply of the printer, by doing it through the quick release power connectors and the power switch. So I'm gonna take a piece of cable and measure where we are gonna place each component. We can connect the cable, for example, to this end of the LED strip, pass it through the power switch, then drive it to the power supply, and right on top of the power supply we will place the quick release power connector. Here I have both components, the male and female power connectors, as well as the power switch. Both will be linked down in the description as well, in case you want to buy them from Amazon. I will place the power switch in a comfortable location here in the top right corner of the gap. And for that, I have designed this small piece to hold everything in place. By the way, as always, you can download all the files from the link in the description. To print this small piece, I've used, as well as with the other parts of the shelving, the orange Sunlu PETG filament that I bought from Amazon, and you can buy from the affiliate link down in the description of the video. I slice them in cura with a 0.2 mm layer high, 2 walls alternating a third one every 2 layers, 3 bottom layers, 4 top layers, and a 20% cubic infill. If you want to learn more about the cura custom settings, you should definitely watch our cura custom settings series, clicking here in the top right corner or in the links in the description. I have designed as well a small cable clip that you can also download from the link in the description. And we'll use to keep the cable of the LED strip attached to the ceiling. Okay, so back with the cable, we're going to measure where we are going to place every component. So we'll mark the position of the power switch with some tape and the position of the quick release connector. I'm going to start with the power switch. Notice that you don't have to cut both wires of the cable, but only one. That will be interrupted or continued by the switch. So we'll peel a portion of 2 to 3 centimeters in length, cut one of the cables in two halves, doesn't matter which one, and we'll braid all the little cables forming a thicker one. Once ready, we are going to weld them to the switch using some tin. Finally, we can use our heat shrink tubing to cover the unions and prevent problems in the future. Now that this part of the circuit is ready, I'm going to install the 3D printed part that I designed to hold the power switch in place. So we'll take the 2 20mm wood screws and insert them in the holes made in the design, passing the screwdriver through the bigger holes designed for it and screw it in place. Once done, we are going to pass the cables through the rectangular hole in the 3D printed piece. Insert the switch in place with a little click, and later insert 2 cables through the hole in the cap of the 3D printed piece, what will give us a nice looking result. Now we just have to stick the LED strip to the ceiling of the table using the double-sided tape that came with the strip. But before, we are going to weld the extreme of the cable to the LED strip with some tin and cover it with heat shrink tubing. Once welded, we will stick it to the ceiling, getting this cool result. Alright, now we just have to cut the cable more or less on top of our 3D printer power supply and use these little screws in the power connectors to attach each part of the cable to its own connector. Once attached, we will connect both parts of the cable using the connector we just installed. And we are going to connect the other extreme to the power supply. Like so. Before doing it, we're gonna make a quick check to see if everything works as it's supposed to, and yes, it does. Alright, so we will attach it to the screws in the power supply and make the final test. Now we'll turn on the LED strip from the switch we just installed, and yes, it works perfectly. Finally, I'm going to use the little cable clips that I designed and printed in red PLA to attach all the insulation to the ceiling, keeping it secure and hidden. Here we have our nice installation. Since we included our quick release power connector, if we have to take our 3D printer out to clean it, fix it, or whatever you want to do with it, we just have to unplug the printer from the power, unplug the small connector we just installed, and easily remove it. Now, in comparison with before, as you can see, there is a big difference in the lighting, and now you can perfectly see if the print is going well or not. Okay, so I also repeated the process with the other 2 3D printers, and look at this amazing result. It is cool, huh? Alright, so that has been everything for this episode. In the next video, I will build the final touch to our amazing 3D printing farm shelving that is going to be installed right here. You should try to guess what it is down below in the comment section. Remember that linked down in the description, you will find the link to download the files that I used in this video, as well as the links to buy all the components of the installation from Amazon. Alright, so start building your 3D printer lighting installation, and now stay tuned for the new content coming in the upcoming weeks. So hit the like button, share the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel clicking here in this little icon. You can also follow us on social networks at Architects3DP to get the latest news, and please consider supporting my work on Patreon to keep making this possible. Besides helping me and making me super happy, you will also get nice rewards that you can check in our Patreon's page, navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp or clicking in the link in the description. Okay, so as always, see you guys in the next video.